Welcome to Feed Dump, where once again I am filling in for Graham. But that's good news, because I am an ankylosaurus. Joining me this week is a T-Rex.
Stay very still, I hunt by movement.
And a brontosaurus.
I'm not a real dinosaur, but you think I am.
Actually, I'm pretty sure that hunt by movement thing is propaganda that the T-Rex invented so that they could hunt easier. It's really easy when everyone stands still.
But of course, dinosaurs are dangerous, so we better charge up our lasers and shoot off some pew-pews. Circuses are fun, right? Wrong. They are pits of danger. A woman in Salina, Kansas had a close scare when she ran into what in the bathroom?
Wait a minute! You're asking us to guess? You're asking this combination of people to guess? That means it's...
Paul and Matt have to figure out what Grant Kathleen is talking about.
A bear wearing a tutu.
The elephants on parade.
I like that guess. Those elephants on parade are terrifying.
The elephants on parade.
Where are they going? Why?
Okay, Dumbo-related childhood traumas aside, it was not anything to do with that. It was, in fact, a tiger. The lady got up to go to the bathroom, and apparently the tiger had the same idea, and wandered in after she started to do her business.
There's some joke here about scaring the shit out of somebody, but I don't know what it is.
Oh wow, this is just like the movie Life of Pi. Except instead of being a majestic tale of survival in a lifeboat on the open sea, it's a 2-minute ordeal in a poorly kept public bathroom facility.
I can see what happened here. Probably the tiger was going to go to the tiger bathroom, but there was a really long line, and he was like, well, I'll just go into the human bathroom. You know, nobody will notice.
Hey, there was some drama. The lady did take her 3-year-old daughter into the bathroom with her, who was completely unharmed, but was very concerned that the tiger had not washed its hands.
You know, this would never happen with Cirque du Soleil.
Yeah, because they don't have tigers at Cirque du Soleil.
Yeah, that was the joke.
Moving on. The manager of an Austrian hotel had a very bad weekend after he became trapped in an elevator for 4 days.
Was there also a tiger in the elevator? Because then that would be a story.
That sounds like a game show.
All right, Matt Wiggins, are you ready to be the next contestant on Who Wants to Be Trapped in an Elevator with a Tiger for 4 days?
He may have been a hotel manager, but he really wanted to move up within his company.
Now, well, 420, aka Smoke Weed Every Day, may not be an official holiday in Canada. I'd have to say it is well observed in our neck of the woods. So, when police in White Rock made a bust for pot cookies, it wasn't such a big deal. Till they discovered 8,000 of them.
Pot cookies? That's not how you make cookies. You make them on a sheet. So it's relevant to note that this news story never actually confirms that the cookies were pot cookies. So I like to think the cops just showed up at this house and confiscated 8,000 cookies on a spurious pot charge. Yeah, those are pot cookies. Just load them into the truck, guys. Load them into the truck.
Mrs. Christie, you're going down!
They're like Chips Ahoy, but in this case there's 1,000 tips in every bag.
Yes, that's correct. We seized 8,000 pot cookies this morning, and we sent all 7,000 of them to the lab to get tested. And the 6,000 we got back, we'll be putting into storage. And if anybody wants to help us possibly get rid of the 2,000 pot cookies, feel free to come by, and we're doing a barbecue, and it should be a lot of fun. I mean, it's gonna be just sweet! I feel like if you're making 8,000 pot cookies, that's actually more of a baking operation than like a growing operation. Like, I can see that these guys would be like baking this and making all the pot cookies, and then like halfway through would be like, you know, I think I just really like making cookies.
Well, it does seem like if you're making pot cookies, that forgetting what you're doing halfway through is very apropos of the situation.
Vietnamese police were pretty shocked when they pulled over a driver and found out he was smuggling 53 king cobras in his car.
Well, this is one police caper that's gonna go down in history.
King cobras can grow to like 18 feet long. If you do the math, that's like a million feet.
Actually, Paul, it's no feet. Because they're snakes?
Matt Wiggins, you're the next contestant on Who Wants to Be in a Car with 53 King Cobras?
Do I have to be?
As much as I hate to interrupt the incredible mental picture you guys are painting here of just a man stuffed in a writhing pile of snakes trying to drive down the road, the snakes were actually being kept in sacks. And it's not like he was just doing this for shits and giggles. He got paid $50 to do that.
That's not even a dollar a snake! Not worth it!
This man has extremely poor negotiating skills.
This does not seem like a scalable business plan.
Alright, I am calling a moratorium on Matt puns after that one, and that unfortunately means the end of the episode. So remember, while there may be better sources for news, they don't have this hat, which will help me get to the bottom of the mystery of how Matt thought he could tell jokes in the first place.
Hey!
Episode's over, Matt!
Meeting a tiger in a bathroom would give me pause.
You're a... You know what? I don't even care anymore.